election and the elections to come.
So are you being discriminated?
Yes, we're being treated. We're being treated like second class citizens.
Did they turn on your mic?
No, they wouldn't even recognize my points of order or anything like that. It's just ironic that they threw out the main state convention and not follow procedures. Here I was clearly calling a point of order and they just ignored me. You know, they said, we're going to move the, without objection, we're going to move the previous question. Well, I think I objected pretty loudly a bunch of times, and they pretended they didn't hear it. So they didn't follow the order. So it's ironic they throw out stuff for not following the rules.
Point of order.
They objected because we had uncredentialed people down on our delegation floor. How many people did you see down on the floor that weren't allowed to vote? There's all kinds of people down there that couldn't vote.
Right, so numerous red tags down on that
floor. Why they threw us out of the state convention, threw our newly elected delegates out. The things that they were doing down here that were worse than what we did. So it's just ironic. And you know, all we wanted was an up or down vote. And they wouldn't even give it to us because they wouldn't even recognize me. They wouldn't allow me to make an amendment. They wouldn't allow me to speak in debate. They wouldn't even answer my point of order. So,
what do you do now?
Red tweet.
I think this only energizes our base. They see things like this. They see the party bosses ruling things. They see the unfair process. So I think it really energizes us just that we need to change things. So we're gonna stick it out. We're gonna get involved at the local level on county committees and state committees. We're gonna support liberty-minded Republican candidates for state legislature. Probably not gonna get involved with that many national campaigns unless there's a good candidate like Ron Paul running. But I think this just energizes us. Our movement's growing. You know, we support the ideas that Ron Paul supports: limited government for government, individual liberty, sound money, non-interventionist foreign policy, and our movement is growing. And I think they're worried about us. You know, at the same time, I think they're worried that our principles are growing in stature. And you know, they sort of see us as a threat, I think. But they, you know, at the local level, they should see us as an asset because we're helping out at the local level, helping liberty-minded candidates. And you know. I think, you know, ultimately we're going to succeed, that our ideas of liberty will succeed. It's just a matter of when.
Did Ron Paul specifically ask you guys to do this in there, to do this?
No, he didn't ask. He had nothing to do with it. You know, he thinks people are all individuals and should act of their own accord and do what they think is right. And that's what we did in there. We thought we wanted an up or down vote to get our duly elected delegates seated. We wanted an up or down vote, and that's what we wanted. We did it because we thought it was right. There was over 2,000 Republicans at the main state convention that elected us. We won by margins of victory over 100 votes. They were claiming there were illegal votes cast, and the people who were contesting us didn't even prove that there was one illegal vote cast, yet we were winning by over 100 votes. So it's just somebody.
He didn't endorse this.
What's that?
He did not.
He didn't know what we were going to do.
He didn't know what you were going to do. Okay. Right, thank you. Can I get your name?
That's Brent Tweed.
Brent.